Alright, salam alaikum, merhaba ve hoş geldiniz and welcome to this next part of Let's Play Empire Total War with Rome Total War just less than a month away. I think we have enough time for just one more little campaign. Let's see now, by the way, it's kind of late right now, which is why I'm talking in a low voice. Don't wake up anyone next door. By next door, I mean next room. But anyway, I am trying to decide, what do you call it? Currently, which faction I should play as. I've already played, just completed Austria, played as Britain, played as Prussia. So now, it's a huge juggle of what to play as. And right now, being that we were mainly in Europe, I want to do something that's mainly in the Americas. So that's either France, Sweden, which I can actually use to, because I would like to conquer North America as the Vikings, Spain, or the Netherlands. And after some careful consideration, I really think that I'm going to effectively go with the Netherlands. Let's see. According to this, if I play a long campaign, I have to include Dutch Guiana, Flanders, Bijapur, Ceylon, Curacao, French Guiana, Mysore, Hindustan, New York, New Andalusia, Netherlands, Goa, and Karnataka. So it's a combination of India and the Americas. Do I want that, or do I want a world domination campaign? I think we'll go with the world domination campaign again, because yeah, that'll do. And let's see, battle difficulty is always on the easiest. What should we have the campaign difficulty as though? Considering if we only have two provinces in Europe, and we're surrounded by a hostile in Spain and France. And considering the fact that we have Rome coming in and I want to finish this campaign as soon as possible, I think we're going to put it on easy difficulty. So, let's commence.
Your home region against the Catholic Spanish, who are seeking to destroy Protestantism and restore superstition and fear to the land.
Of course.
Following that, capturing Flanders would not only expel the Spanish from Northern Europe, it would also unite all Netherlanders under a single banner. It's important to make and maintain alliances with other Protestant nations. You're already allied to Britain by virtue of William of Orange's position on the throne of England, and the military might of Prussia could make them an important ally. You should also try to expand your colonial possessions in the Caribbean Sea. Trade is an essential part of Dutch culture, so keep sending Indiaman merchant ships to the trade theatres in the South Atlantic, East Indies, off the coast of Africa, and your colonies in the Caribbean and Ceylon. Maintain a navy to patrol your sea trade routes and protect them from attack.
Yeah, because as we all know, the Dutch and the Italians are the most Christian Jews in existence, ultimately because they're so good with money, yet they're not Jewish. Okay, I already have a trade port in the East Indies. Definitely gonna want to protect that. Anyway, let us commence. Alright, salaamu alaikum, merhaba, and we are back, and, good news and bad news. The, good news is, well, I had to re-update my computer because, Jesus, I had not updated it in over 2 months, so it was slow as hell. But, also good news is that we have, taken Trinidad and Tobago and gotten another, sugar plantation, and that has taken another province from the pirates. And now we are about to besiege the last part, the last little island, their home island, the Leeward Islands, and effectively kick them out of the game, thus ending piracy early. The bad news is, however, is we're only making 872 income per turn because we have a huge navy and a huge army, but unfortunately we haven't been able to do much with it. The real problem is back here at home in Amsterdam, actually. Because I am still awaiting, I cannot really decode war with any of my neighbors. Hanover and Westphalia are either friendly or have powerful allies. I'm currently, by default, the game has allied me with Britain and Austria. However, I'm waiting for Spain, I'm just waiting for it to do something aggressive. It, unfortunately, Spain already killed off one of my rakes. But I cannot be the aggressor, because if I am the aggressor, there's a chance France might join in on the war as well. And, when the AI attacks you, there's less chances that their allies will join you. When you, the aggressor, generally, people really like to be allied with the nation that is the aggressor. But, I didn't realize that France is almost split down the middle. You just need to bring those two together and France is almost split down the middle. Practically France and Iberia are cut off from the rest of Europe, but yeah, anyway, so, and the thing is, I would like to take this army and just sail all the way down to North Africa and take over all of North Africa, as I usually do, but thing is, the minute I leave, I know Spain or France is going to do something stupid and knock me out of the game. France really has nothing. I could easily take Flanders, but I've just recently, right here, I've seen a pretty huge French army, and you have to understand that when you're the Netherlands, you are in a really bad position, because there's nothing wrong with starting off with a few provinces. Like Prussia, for instance, starts off with a few provinces, but Prussia is an aggressive nation, and I'm already surrounded by a potential huge enemy I can conquer in the form of the Austrians, and then later on sweep down to Italy, and then take over France, etc., etc. That's not the case with the Netherlands. In the Netherlands, I have some really, really, France and Spain are already my immediate allies. It's not like, Prussia, where I could just build up my forces and then, it's really hard and difficult, but, anyway, the Swedish have been, on a campaign of quite beautiful success. They have successfully taken St. Petersburg from the Russians, and they've taken Copenhagen and Christina, Norway from the, Denmarks. Effectively making them a very strong power in the Baltic, and effectively reducing the Denmarks to just Iceland. Meanwhile, also the traditional three-way war between Prussia, Poland, and Austria is broken out, with Prussia and Poland formerly being an alliance against the Austrians, but apparently relationships kind of grew sour, and now their alliance recently broke. Poland, I thought, was about to, and who knows, they might still be able to. I've noticed in recent games the Polish AI, an Ottoman campaign that I'm doing, which is, I'm not recording it, it's just for my own entertainment, for my own lulls. Poland has become the second most powerful nation after me, effectively taking over most of Europe, even France. And then you saw in my Great Britain campaign how powerful the Polish and unfriendly they were becoming, to the point where I had to abandon India and regrettably take over Europe as Britain, because I so did not want to do that, but Poland wasn't giving me much of a choice. Anyway, Poland had recently taken Hungary. The Austrians took it back, but that is already a bad sign of an aggressive Polish AI. I do not like aggressive Polish AI. Meanwhile, the Barbary states have also had their revolution and have become a republic. The Mughals, I should also point out that, as in the Netherlands, I also have a Indian front. I'm currently trying to build up a little bit of an army in Sierra Leone. The Marathas, they're doing moderately well against the Mughals. Generally, they're usually sweeping like crazy, but, I don't know, they're taking their sweet time. The Mughals aren't exactly, letting go that easily. They also had a revolution and became a temporary republic, but now it seems they reverted back to a monarchy. I'm still waiting to make grabs. Apparently, Spain, I should also note, wiped out Portugal. And unfortunately, I thought Goa was going to fall under rebels, but instead it goes by default to the Maratha Confederacy, which I find to be absolutely stupid beyond comprehension. Meanwhile, nothing new within the Ottoman Empire. Everything seems to be still quiet and so, despite the fact that the Russians have, by default, taken over the Crimea. And with the and of course, Spain, I believe, is already at war with Britain since it attacked Portugal, am I correct? Oh no, they're actually at peace. In fact, Spain is only at war right now. Spain is actually at war with the Mughals. Must be due to trade reasons. They're of course at war with the Cherokee and the Plains and with pirates. And of course they are listed as unfriendly now. I still don't trust them as far as I could throw them, which is pretty damn far. France is also unfriendly because we had historically, like during the 1670s, 1680s, me and Louis XIV had gone to war. We're apparently friendly towards Austria, despite it is a Catholic country. We'd like to know what is exactly the relationship between the Netherlands and Austria for it to be friendly like that. Because one thing I know for certain is this. Britain and Portugal were allies, but that was because during the 1640s, when Charles II took back the throne, he married a princess of the who was a daughter of the King of Portugal, which has therefore sealed a long-lasting alliance between Britain and Portugal, despite Portugal being a devout Catholic country and Britain being a heretical Protestant country. Don't know what's the relationship between me and the Austrians, though. Ottomans are actually proving to be a pain in the ass, though. They're apparently allied with Sweden, anyway, but they are a pain in the ass. I've been trying to make negotiations with them, and they are as hard-headed as it can come. And I can tell you, personally, from experience, Turks are very reasonable people. But then again, we are dealing with a computer AI now, aren't we? Sweden is, meanwhile, let's see, it's actually at war with Prussia and Russia. And Hanover. It's actually got a lot of enemies and has only got the Ottoman Empire as an ally. Due to the fact that I only have one port in my home region, I only have enough trading for four nations. Let's see. Westphalia is friendly. And apparently they find trade unacceptable. Why? When I'm a considerable trading power, I should also mention by default I already have one ship trading port in the East Indies. Anyway, my main idea for this campaign is mainly to become more of a political international power rather than a European power, because that's how I want to do my games. I want to have one game. I want to play as a faction that focuses mainly on the conquest of Europe and what have you, and then another faction that tries to conquer internationally. Prussia was all about Europe. Britain, I tried to make international, but unfortunately, Poland would not let me have that and forced me to conquer them, thus making Britain a European power, which is not what I had in mind. Austria, of course, was by default a European power. However, as the Netherlands, I am strongly trying to keep the rest of Europe to eat itself up while I build an American and Indian Empire. Well, anyway, enough of that update. It's time to finish off these goddamn pirates once and for all. I should also point out Dutch. I was very hesitant to do a Dutch campaign because Dutch is, from my understanding, a family language to German. In fact, several of my friends who speak German tell me that when they speak to people who speak Dutch, they can understand like over 75% of what they're saying. I mean, it's, I guess, the kind of the relationship that Portuguese and Spanish have towards one another. But So, and for the fact that we just did Austria, which is a German-speaking country, I'm getting kind of tired of the German, but Dutch also has a lot of English-sounding words as well. Like, they actually say "order sir," which is like okay. I don't need to speak Dutch to understand that. But anyway, let's finish off these goddamn pirates, shall we?